Fox 5 News Now, sponsored by SDCCU.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome into Fox 5 News Now, San Diego's only interactive digital newscast. My name is Matt Meyer here as your host, and we are brought to you, as always, by San Diego County Credit Union. Hey, as I said, this is an interactive news show, so as I go today, please first let me know where you're watching from. I always like to see where folks are tuning in from. You can do that in the comments there or in the chat feature on fox5sandiego.com and on the Fox 5 app. And then as we go today, let me know if you have comments or questions about our stories. I do like to see those. Lots to get to today, including updates on that chaotic scene in Virginia Beach, which we first brought you as breaking news last night. But to start with, we're taking a live look right now at our San Diego Convention Center. That is because that's the big news today. The first group of unaccompanied kids will arrive at a new shelter at the San Diego Convention Center today. These are unaccompanied minors who came across the border, again, without a parent or a guardian, and who are seeking asylum here in the U.S. The reason why they're coming to San Diego is some of the images that you see on your screen there now. Border facilities, especially in Texas, are getting overcrowded. Officials also say that these facilities are not really intended for kids to begin with. So again, this group, a pretty large group of girls, mostly between the ages of 13 and 17, for this first group who are headed to San Diego today, are going to be coming in on multiple flights as the day goes on. So we are going to be following that closely. Again, this because the border facilities in Texas are getting overcrowded. So we use our San Diego Convention Center, which you see on your screen here now, for that purpose. These are kids, again, who came into the U.S. alone seeking asylum from violence and other dangerous conditions, whether natural disasters, extreme poverty, in their home countries in Central America. Now, the Biden administration has changed the way that it's approaching these cases, which is why we are seeing a larger number of these kids being actually held by the U.S. government. So, because of a rule put in place first by the Trump administration, and now the Biden administration has kept that rule in place called Title 42 during the pandemic, for health reasons, the U.S. government says they are turning away most adults who come across the border seeking asylum right now, again, citing the pandemic. However, what the Biden administration has changed is the way that it handles these cases with unaccompanied minors. And again, now the U.S. government saying that we will keep them in shelters here and try to get them to a sponsor while they wait for their case to play out. Two of our prominent local leaders, Mayor Todd Gloria and County Supervisor Nathan Fletcher, say that this plan is the right thing to do.
Because it's the right thing to do. These are children. Some of them are very young. They're very vulnerable, and they need our help. And what I know about my hometown, San Diego, is that we are a welcoming city, and this is a time for us to prove that.
We have a building that will be vacant until July. We have a willing federal partner that wants to help us provide compassion and empathy and support to these children. And 90% of them have family members here in the United States.
And so the reason why Fletcher there is emphasizing that most of these kids have family here in the U.S. is because shelters like this, certainly border facilities meant to be a very short-term solution, but even a shelter like this, like we're seeing here in San Diego now, these are supposed to be a short-term stopgap measure. They're going to operate for no more than 3 months, officials say, as they find sponsors for the kids to stay with. And again, that's usually what Fletcher is referring to with family members that they have in the U.S. Those people will actually take care of them while the asylum process plays out. Now, the other element of this, of course, involving our San Diego Convention Center is, as you see, some of the last people who were using that space as a homeless shelter have now moved out, and people were curious about the timing of this. The city says that they were already planning on winding down the kind of pandemic era homeless shelter that we've seen at the convention center. Again, they're saying that there was a much smaller number of people there staying at the convention center. The success that they had was over 1,000 people who came to the center initially have now found long-term or permanent housing. But with that being said, the people who were still staying there, the city has assured us that they are going to be transferring those people to city shelters. So again, the timing of this was very close, but the city saying that they were already planning on winding down the homeless shelter, and now it is a shelter of a different kind. You're seeing on your screen some of the cots that they had set out. When we asked the city how much of what was used for the homeless shelter would be carried over directly to be used for this new shelter, they said that some of those details were still being worked out, but you're getting at least a rough idea of what this space might look like, because again, they were just using it for a shelter of a different kind. Now, not all local leaders, we heard from Gloria and Fletcher, who were kind of integral in making this happen, not all local leaders have been pleased with the way that the plan came together. Here's El Cajon Mayor Bill Wells on Fox this week, criticizing what he views as a lack of consultation with the community before this plan was put in place.
And my question is, where's the process? I mean, this didn't have any public hearings. It didn't go before the city council. Public didn't get a chance to weigh into this whatsoever. And, you know, the convention center is a public asset. It's paid for by hotel TOT dollars. And I think the public has a right to know what's happening and what the plans are.
So you hear Wells there sharing his thought on the way that this plan actually came together. He is not the only local official to criticize this plan. Congressman Daryl Issa recently elected again, this time to represent the East County area, so same kind of area as Wells. He told the San Diego Union-Tribune this week, and this is a quote, California is paying an extraordinary price for the Biden administration's border crisis. And that is an echo of what we've heard from other Republican lawmakers. Right now, you're looking at video of some GOP senators who toured the border in Texas this week. They have blamed the Biden administration's approach to immigration, which they believe is too permissive, for actually encouraging people to come. It is worth for just a second to give a little bit of context to this. Of course, the Biden administration and Democrats have instead been emphasizing, they say that, first of all, the conditions in some of these Central American countries have become worse, and that is why people are coming to the border. They have also downplayed whether or not we're actually seeing a significant spike in encounters and in people coming to the U.S. To seek asylum in the first place. They're saying that when you look at it over time, there are fluctuations in the amount of people who are migrating to the U.S., and that especially happens in the cold months. Now, that is true, but it is also worth noting that right now, specifically, the number of unaccompanied minors, so the kinds of people who, the kids that we have coming to San Diego starting today, that number of kids who are coming to the U.S. to seek asylum without an adult, that is at its highest numbers on record, or at least one of the highest numbers on record for that kind of migration. It is worth also noting, however, that going back 8 months, so into the Trump administration, we had been seeing a rise in border migration overall. So the reality is we right now are at our highest number of people coming to the border. You see Biden on the screen there at his first press conference, where again, he shared some of those things that I was talking about. But again, we are at our highest number since a stretch back in 2019. But again, conflicting explanations for that. It's also often more complicated than you're going to hear from one side or another, but that's a little bit of a breakdown of the context in which some of this is happening here in San Diego starting today.
Fox 5 News Now, sponsored by SDCCU.
So thanks again as we look one more time at that San Diego Convention Center, which is certainly going to be the focus of a lot of news in the week to come. I do want to say hi to some of you who are spending your Saturday morning with me. I do appreciate you folks tuning in. So let's see. I want to say hi to a couple of you. Beverly is watching from the great city of San Diego. I see that Jill is tuning in from Solana Beach. Rogelio is watching from Bakersfield, California. I see that Carlos and Lise were a couple of the first people into the chat. So thanks to you folks for tuning in. Wanted to give you a little shout out. I see that Michael is watching from Oceanside. I know Michael is a regular. Michael, thanks so much for tuning in again. Let's see, I see that Muriel is watching from Hemet. I see Barry is in Del Mar, and Linda also watching from San Diego. I see Cecilia is watching in Miramar, and April says good morning to me. Hey, April, thank you so much for tuning in. Lots of you folks here, and so I do want to get to more of your comments, and I will be sure to let you know as we go on today. If you have questions or comments, I'll read out a few of those now. Scrolling through again, don't want to miss anybody, but I think we are going to for now turn back to the news today, because I do have a major development in this story that we first brought you as breaking news last night. You may have seen this on the Fox 5 app or on the Fox 5 news at 11 p.m. A chaotic and violent night in Virginia Beach last night. So if you're not familiar, this was in the Virginia Beach oceanfront. So that's like right along the boardwalk there. It's a really popular tourist destination and entertainment district. Here's what we know starting this morning when we got a pretty significant update from our partners there. 10 people total were wounded in a total of 3 shootings. So this was actually a pretty spread out event, but it did all happen in that same area. You're seeing video there of police did detain and question quite a few people, but we don't yet have a solid total on the number of arrests. Here's what we know. This all started with a shooting scene on Atlantic Avenue. That's the main drag there near the boardwalk. Police heard gunshots and they showed up to that area. By the time they got there, they found 8 people had been wounded in a shooting, but there was no immediate sign of the gunman. While police were working on their investigation there, they actually heard gunshots nearby, and this was just a short time later. So they headed over there, they sent some officers over that way, and they did come into contact with a suspect. They have not said whether or not this person who they ended up exchanging gunfire with, or excuse me, who they ended up firing at, they did not say if the person was necessarily suspected in that previous shooting, but they said he was suspected of some kind of crime. A confrontation happened and police shot and killed that man. So we had the 8 people wounded in the first shooting, police investigating gunshots in a second case. They say that something threatened them and that they ended up shooting and killing this man. Again, there is going to, of course, be a in-depth investigation into that police shooting like we always do. But again, officers shoot and kill that man. Now, around the time that they were dealing with those 2 different scenes, a 10th person, a woman, was found dead from a gunshot wound. And police don't right now believe that she was actually a victim of the first shooting or of that shooting involving police. So that's 3 shootings total, 10 people shot and 2 people killed. As far as those other people who were wounded in, again, this violent, chaotic night, you're looking at video here of a crash that was involved. There were a variety of different chaotic things that were playing out all at once. But again, the 8 people who were sent to the hospital, they're in varying states. We have not gotten a specific update on their status this morning, but I will be sure to bring you that. Again, a police chief who was interviewed at the scene reflecting on how much they had to sort through.
What you can see is we have a very chaotic incident, a very chaotic night in the beach, many different crime scenes. We had an officer that was struck by a car. He has been transported to the hospital. I'm told non-life-threatening injuries.
So again, there, he even mentioned that an officer was hit by a car in all of the chaos, and it's not clear yet which scene that was involved in. So as I said, and as you saw on your screen briefly earlier, they did detain and question quite a few people. But for now, we don't have word of any specific arrests. As we go today, I'll be sure to update you more on this story. Again, a violent, chaotic night there in Virginia Beach. Thank you again for joining me on Fox 5 News Now. Want to get you to more new video from overnight. It was a busy one. This is back here at home in the Southcrest area. So this, you're looking right now at flames in an apartment, through an apartment window. This fire broke out overnight. A woman and her dog were able to escape those flames in that woman's bedroom. This, again, in Southeast San Diego. This is the Southcrest neighborhood on National Avenue near the 15 freeway. The fire was contained to the bedroom you're seeing on your screen. Eventually, what firefighters were able to do is pry those bars off of the window. Meanwhile, they ran hose lines toward, like you just saw on your screen there, and they were eventually able to get the fire out. You see one of those firefighters actually dumping debris out of the window to get anything else that might be still smoldering or flaming. So again, the good news here, that woman and her dog were able to escape this fire, but authorities did say that it was too badly damaged for her to stay there. You actually saw briefly on your screen, she did have family members who were able to come and help her find a place to stay. We talked to a battalion chief at the scene of that fire who said that if it weren't for the quick work of these firefighters, it could have spread throughout the apartment building potentially, but they were able to contain those flames to just that bedroom there in Southcrest. Again, as you look at them working on that when the flames were still going, good news there, no one was hurt. But of course, this apartment badly damaged. Wanted to get you that update, new from overnight.
Fox 5 News Now, sponsored by SDCCU.
Thanks again to you folks for tuning in. Again, we've been looking at this live shot from our Hilton Bayfront camera, but I try to mix it up a little bit for you. We actually had a shot of Julian this morning. I wanted to see if I could pull that up. Hey, there it is. So that's kind of cool. You know, we are going to get to your forecast a little bit later with Brad Wills there for you. I wanted to give you this live look. Excuse me, this isn't Julian. This is the Laguna Mountain Lodge. I'm mixing up our local mountains. So there you go. It's the Laguna Mountain Lodge. You can see little bit of snow still on the roof there. Cars passing by. It should be a beautiful day up in our local mountains. Our weather's been a little bit up and down, and we're actually headed for another warm-up very soon. Before I get to Brad, I do want to answer a couple more of your questions, or at least give some of you folks a shout-out. Let me bear with me as I read through these. I see that Steve Kingman is watching in Arizona. Steve, thanks so much for tuning in. I see that Cynthia is watching from Bishop. Thank you, Cynthia, for being here to hang out with me on Fox 5 News Now. I see that Yvette is here and Becky is watching. I see that Jesus is watching as well. Wanted to say hello to a few others who are hanging out watching the show this morning. Again, as we go, let me know what you're up to on this Saturday. If you don't have a specific question or a comment about one of our stories today, I'll be sure to get to a couple more of your, just letting me know where what's going on today. I see that Susan is tuning in. She was wondering if some of the homeless folks who were staying at that shelter, I believe is what she's asking about, if they've been given a safe, warm place to stay. So what the city has told us about the folks who have been moved out of that homeless shelter that was previously operating out of the San Diego Convention Center, what they have told us is that the number of people staying at the shelter had dwindled to the point where they were already planning on moving people into existing city shelters. So they say that anyone who wanted to was transferred from the convention center to one of their city shelters. But again, one of the main things that they were touting was actually that they were able to find housing for about more than 1,000 of the unsheltered folks who originally came to the convention center. They said that they were able to find them a permanent or at least a long-term home. So that is good news. Susan, I hope that speaks at least a little bit to what you were asking about. Again, taking a live look from our Laguna Mountain Lodge camera here. Say hello to a couple more of you. I see, let's see. Thought I had one more that I wanted to get to. I see that Bridge is tuning in, if I haven't said hello to you yet. Yeah, folks, I'll leave it there for now. But again, as I go today, let me know if you have questions or comments about these stories that I'm working on here for you, including this next one. It's the tale of our weather. Brad Wills is in an especially good mood, folks. I think you're going to enjoy this forecast. Here he is for a little bit about whether you're going to see a bit more of the sunshine that you see on your screen here, or if we have a little bit more rain in our forecast.
Hi, everybody. How are you? How's your weekend going so far? Good. Weather's going to be pretty nice today. Temperatures jumping up compared to yesterday. We're going to take you back. We're going to recap what happened as far as the weather's concerned last week, and then we'll get you next week here. And boy, we got some nice weather on the way. This is on Wednesday, Lane Tackett in Cardiff at low tide there. Beautiful shot of the water, and you notice those high clouds coming in ahead of our storm system on Thursday. And this is where we get these rain clouds. Wow, look at the angry ocean and the dark skies on Thursday in Ocean Beach. Now things are going to change for us. That area of low pressure, the broadest of rain is out. It's out in the middle of the country. Now we've got high pressure sitting right over our region right here. Oh, it's all about that H. High pressure offshore flow warming it up and drying us out big time as we head to Sunday. You notice this right here, another area of low pressure that'll cool us down on Monday and Tuesday. But let's focus on the weekend, today and tomorrow, right? Look at the numbers. Today, we're going to talk about temperatures in the upper 60s and low 70s at the beaches. 72 downtown San Diego. La Mesa, 78, 74, Bonita, 72, and Tijuana, up in the mountains, pretty nice day. Mostly sunny skies again. We'll start off with the offshore flow, some weak Santa Ana winds. 63 Mount Laguna, 70 in Julian, 82 in Borrego Springs. Perfect day in Ramona, 75, and the same in Encinitas. Actually, we'll jump up to 76, but a pair of 75s for San Marcos and Escondido, 76 in Fallbrook. I like that for you. Going to surf today, mixed swell in the water, 2 to 4 footers. Big high tide was at 8:50 this morning at a 5.5. Now we're going to drain out in the afternoon at 3:20 at a negative 0.7. Here, are you ready for it? is all 7 days, ring, ring, ding, 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 on your television screen. Is that what you're watching on? Oh, you're probably watching on the computer right now. 72 today, but 79 on Sunday. Beautiful weather then. We drop a little bit Monday and Tuesday, back up Wednesday and Thursday with the offshore flow, upper 70s, close to 80 degrees, some moderate Santa Ana winds, and I'll keep you posted. Inland Valleys, check this out, everybody. 78 today, gorgeous. By Sunday, we're at 87 degrees, a little bit cooler for Monday and Tuesday. That's that low pressure, then high pressure for Wednesday and Thursday. But man, Sunday, 87 degrees, that feels a lot like
this summertime.
All right, shake it, everybody. Hope you have a great weekend. My name is Brad Wills. This has been a pleasure. Let's get it back over to Matt.
Truly exceptional stuff from Brad Wills, folks. I think that he, rolls out of bed like that. I think he hops out of bed. He's immediately in his suit, looking camera ready, and he's ready to have a good time with you because he really feels at home doing the forecast for us, doesn't he? I never know what to expect with Brad, and once again, he didn't disappoint there, folks. And he also got you plenty of good information about your weather. Hey, let's give you another look around our city while I'm at it. Why don't you? I'll give you a look from our city camera. It's going to be a gorgeous day, folks. Let me know what you're getting up to. Are you going to go out on a hike? You headed out for, let's see, a little bit of brunch. Sometimes I lose track of what time it is here on Fox 5 News Now. Yeah, headed out for some brunch, perhaps. Let me know what you're up to today. I'll try to read a few more of your comments as we go today. Hey, in the meantime, though, I wanted to actually bring you one of our top stories on Fox5SanDiego.com and on the Fox 5 app. Good time to mention, by the way, that the best way to watch this show is on that Fox 5 app. It's available both for Android and for Apple devices. You get an alert before I go live, and you can actually watch it right there on the app. And again, I always try to keep an eye on what the top stories are on the app today, what you folks are interested in. So we got information about this bust in El Cajon yesterday that a lot of people are interested in. Saw this pop a lot on social media as well. So you're looking at images from inside this illegal pot shop. One of the things that authorities say was most devious about this shop, so to speak, is some of the candies and other snacks that you're seeing there on your screen. Apparently that this place is accused of actually packaging things in what looks like, you know, the official Skittles or Sour Patch products, but of course they are actually THC infused. But again, the primary issue with this marijuana dispensary was simply that it was not properly licensed. It wasn't operating within the regulations that do allow, of course, our legal marijuana industry here. So the Sheriff's Department says that the shop, this is on Oro Street near Broadway, when they raided it, they seized about 100 pounds of cannabis. They took hundreds of pounds of edibles and concentrates, plus $6,000 in cash and a gun. Again, a lot of you folks, I think in particular, you don't see this as often with the brand names being mixed in so directly with some of the products at these illegal shops. Did want to show you that because a lot of you folks seem to be interested in what was going on there. Hey, a bust of a different kind, by the way. Have you been hearing about these catalytic converter thefts? This is something that I have a friend bring up to me probably once or, you know, every other week. People talking about this because they either know someone who got one stolen or they've seen a news story about it. So you just saw those large piles. Let me actually, I'll pull back up El Cajon. I want to show you those piles one more time. There you go. So look at that. So a bust involving 300 converters. So this was up in NorCal. This was in Marin County. They say that it's the largest bust of its kind in that area ever. And we have seen reports that catalytic converter thefts are rising, not just here in San Diego County, but across the country. Certainly you saw there in Marin County, they are nabbing a lot of them. Now, these are those devices underneath your car. Thieves have found out a pretty efficient way to snip those out and take them. The reason why they're taking these devices is because they are actually able to sell them for precious metals. So there in Marin County, someone walked by the storage unit and apparently saw a couple cutting up catalytic converters there. They called the, I believe it was the Sheriff's Department who got involved in this investigation. They showed up and they actually arrested that couple. Now, they found receipts that said that, and I want to get this number correctly, yes, they found receipts showing that they had sold 2,500 of them just since January. And they were actually selling them to a recycler here in SoCal. But again, the reason why I'm showing you this story in San Diego, not just because they were actually being sold to a recycler down here in Southern California, this is very common. We talked to local authorities not too long ago about that. They've seen a spike in that. Toyota Priuses, like you're seeing on your screen here, they are the number one victims. Drivers of those cars get those stolen all the time. Apparently, they are particularly easy to swipe. Now, there is actually something that you can do about this. You could actually get your converter welded to your car, but more common are security devices, like a couple of brands are Cat Shield or Cat Clamp are a couple of these devices. Those cost like less than $200, though authorities warn they're enough probably to deter a thief from getting your catalytic converter. They'd probably just say, I'm not going to mess with this and move on, but technically they are still not foolproof. So let me know in the comments, have you or has someone you know actually had their converter stolen? Have you heard about these crimes? Because we do seem to be seeing a whole lot of them. Well, in the meantime, I always promise here on Fox 5 News Now to leave you with a smile. This is my favorite story of the week. Take a look at this.
Yeah, just hand them to me now.
Oh, look at them! Those are babies!
Oh, those Humane Society officers. Every time we get a video of them doing something incredible like this, we always hear their best, little talking to animals voices. They do it too. Look at them. They keep coming. These are newborn puppies who were rescued from under. There they are. There with mom. How cute is that? So these are newborn puppies that were actually rescued from under a car in the Valencia Park area. Again, this is another story that has popped big time on our website and on Instagram, which I posted this video to yesterday. So these Humane Society officers did an incredible job. They found out about a stray that had given birth under that car, like you were seeing there. They were able to pull them one by one out, like you're seeing here now. And I mean, she can just hold them in the palm of her hand. It's the cutest thing in the world. So these little newborns, they actually pulled 10 of them out one by one. Now, sadly, one of the puppies did die, but 9 of them and the mother who actually gave birth to them under that car, they were all rescued. They were taken to a Humane Society shelter in Mission Valley, and they will be up for adoption soon. How cute is that? You see them there again, resting safely at the convention center. You know, a lot of people don't actually realize that our San Diego Humane Society has a law enforcement component. They have those officers who can go out there and help animals in need. I just love that story. I thought it was the sweetest thing. Let's listen to him one more time pulling them out, because I just think it's really sweet how this officer just melts once he gets a look at one of these newborn puppies.
Yeah, just hand them to me now.
Oh, look at them! Those are babies!
Just too cute. You love to see it, folks, and I love to leave you with a smile. I hope that this story did it. Wanted to get a couple more of your comments here, because why not? We're here at the end of the show. I wanted to say hi to Lorene, who saw that story about the catalytic converters, and she was actually saying that both Lakeside and Santee have seen an increase in those catalytic converters stolen. I'll pull up that image for you one more time. Just look at them all stacked up in that storage facility. Again, apparently someone walked by and saw a couple hacking these things up, and they said, something about that doesn't look right. Sure enough, they gave authorities a call, and they found that large cache of those converters. So interesting to hear there, Lorene, from you, that you've heard about a surge in those getting stolen there in Lakeside and Santee. I wanted to say hello to a couple more of you before I get out of here. Let's see. I see that Cindy says good morning, and she says that she loved Brad's dance moves. Yes, Cindy, Brad truly brought it today. I thought that he did a great job, and I think you all did a great job letting me know your thoughts as we went today. Sorry if I didn't get to you, but I think I got quite a few going. That is it for this Saturday's edition of Fox 5 News Now. I'll be back tomorrow, Sunday at 10 a.m. I look forward to seeing you then. In the meantime, one more big thanks to San Diego County Credit Union for sponsoring the show. Make sure you get that Fox 5 app so you get an alert tomorrow and you can watch the show there. And again, take care. Enjoy this beautiful Saturday. I will see you tomorrow.
Fox 5 News Now, sponsored by SDCCU.